Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And do you see something different? Fellas, do you see something different? Yes, obviously we are playing with a girly FOCH B just because of the Sakura camo. Anyways, the first upgrade of the stream happened. Actually, the second upgrade of the stream happened. We have a new light, so my face is actually looking completely normal right now, and that's how everything is looking like. So here you go. This is not a new camera yet. We are thinking which kind of camera we are going to buy, and more likely it's going to happen in approximately 1 month. I don't want to say the date, but yeah. And today we are going to play with a FOCH B. The tank, which is very, very interesting. By the way, this week you are going to have the two best battles with a FOCH tier 9. Just saying, informing you about this. And anyways, today we are playing with a FOCH B, right? When I'm marking this tank, and currently I am marking this vehicle on the Rus server, right? I'm going with a full gold. For this video, I won't use the full gold, but overall I'm playing with a full APCR. So far we have close to 4000 average damage and 500 average assisting damage, which is bloodyful. But once again, this vehicle is not the most flexible tank, especially when you are playing with a in a ridge line, because how everything is looking like then it's looking like this. You see what you are seeing, fellas? Do you see what you are seeing? Yes, guys. And then you get the point what I'm saying, right? It's not the most flexible vehicle, and this is the worst thing about this tank, but we are going to try to make this tank work. For this video, I will try not to spam too many APCRs, but if we will need to do so, we are going with APCRs, which is completely fine and completely understandable, right? Once again, we are living in World of Tanks in 2020, and let's get real. Everyone can afford at least a couple of clips of APCRs. I know, very unpopular opinion, and I am that guy which is saying not to spam gold if you don't need that, but in certain situations, in certain tanks, I would highly recommend to have only the full gold loadout. For example, the FOCH B, since to get a good game with this tank, it can be complicated, and it can be, let's say like that, very, very, very tricky overall. Anyways, what do we have right here? We have the Corridor Pass, fellas. Corridor Pass is a map. Let's see what we can. Can we make this vehicle work here or not? Matchmaking is okay-ish. It's not horrible matchmaking. We are fighting against the tier 9s. So, minus one matchmaking if I can say so. And let's try to make this vehicle work, right? By the way, next week or this week when the video is released, you are going to see quite some battles with a FOCH B in the Twitch channel, right? I will try to get up to 100%, and in the same time, I am currently working on 8000 damage mission. I did 8000 damage on the tier 9 once, and you are going to see everything yourself very, very, very soon. Anyways. The first things first, Piri Piri heading over there, and we will try to punish people which is crossing like this. Hopefully we are going to do that. If not, then not. Anyways, waiting. That's not what I expected, and I'm getting outspotted. That sucks. And as you can see, 1390 was sitting over there, and he simply outspotted me. Not much what I can change right there, and not much what I can do about this. Sad story, it's okay. Next. How about the standard B and Leo? Maybe we can find the angle how we could dugsh, burst them, and then life would be beautiful. This is the question, and E3 is playing over there. Interesting, very, very interesting. The best thing about this tank is it has a chance to catch someone which is making a mistake, and then you can pretty much clip that person without even asking his name. This is the best thing of all this, right? By the way, pay attention how many of them is over there. This is crazy. This guy is more likely dead. Unfortunately, the angle was way too great, and we did not manage it to hit him right here, which is kind of sad thing, but hey, what can you do, fellas? What can you do? Okay, How about something more sneaky? How about if we would knock this tree down like this? Ooh, Art is saying, how about if I will knock you out? How about that? Okay, we took one for the team from the Jeff. Not much what I can do about this. And we are simply waiting until the standard B is going to make one or another stupidity or one or another mistake. That's what I would love to see, right? But it's not that simple, it's not that easy. How about if we are building a better angle against that type 4? And cupola shot. Maximum roll, by the way. And cupola shot. And frontal shot. And good. Good. So, you see, if I would have a PCR clip right here, I would burst him in the face without even asking his name. That would be the main difference between the APs, which have okay penetration, 257 is not horrible, but APCRs have 325, which is so much better. Plus, on top of that, the shell velocity is definitely better on the APCR, so this is the main reason why you want to have APCRs as a main ammunition of this vehicle. Plus, on top of that, my lovely friends, this tank is not very flexible. You don't have a turret, so you will get yourself like... there is a big chance you are going to get yourself quite horrible situations with this vehicle, right? I'm just trying to find this guy where the flying F he is sitting at, and I'm just bursting the blind shots over there. None of them connected, by the way, just for information. I tried to get as much use as I could, but I failed. It is completely fine. Next, what do we want to do next? Okay, there is a Jackpiston Tortoise which is thinking about making a hardcore pressure like this, and you know what? I believe it is about the time to have the safe defense parameter. Because I want to believe this Jackpiston is going to eliminate those guys one by one, and after that, our team is going to be in a big trouble. So with this tank, it's pretty much how to explain that. This vehicle is the tank with which you want to catch when enemy is making a mistake. It's assault tank, right? You are sitting in the bush and you are waiting till the moon will light green, and then you are going to kill them all. This is pretty much what do you want to do with this vehicle. It's not going to be easy, it's not going to be very very flexible vehicle overall, but whenever you are going to catch someone who is making mistake, oh boy, I can tell you that they are going to regret their life options and their life choices, okay? I can promise you that. So for example, right here we are simply waiting until this Jackpiston or Tortoise is going to go too more aggressively like this. This is the best thing what we can do right here. Play a bit safer. Once again, this is only my opinion and I might be wrong, but that's what I think about this tank, fellas. And here we go. 1, 2. 3, 4, 5. Here we go. Gun finito, eliminated. What Jackpiston? I want to report missing Jackpiston, fellas. I want to report missing Jackpiston because that guy was spotted the other day and he is gone. I don't know how, I don't know why, and where, but he is missing. You see, this vehicle can be good in the certain situations when the sky is blue and when the S are red, but that's it. Nothing more than that, my lovely friends. Nothing more than that. So, what we are going to do now, we are simply waiting until this motion will go like this, because he should be somewhere close, or relatively close, that's what I think. So we are just simply chilling. By the way, this art is a FOCH. And this Arta is a fucker. I can't blame him. I mean, I'm already impressed he's not drowning himself, so. Okay, we are going on the reload. I really want to have a full clip right here. So far, 3000 done, and I am afraid the most of the enemy Artas, right? That's what I am afraid the most. It's okay. Not a big deal. And all we can do in this battle is the last final clip over there, okay? That's what we can do, and that's for what we are preparing mentally, right? Whenever the guys will start going aggressively for us like this, we are going to go in front and we are going to say shnai, 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 shnai. We are going to start clipping them. The biggest problem is this tortoise, in my opinion, because he have the most hit points right there. This guy got tracked, this guy got effed. Now this guy is pretty much in the open field for us, so we are just simply going for him and we are trying to eliminate him from the game. Last shot, boom. Good, we are going on the reload right there because it is important, and now we have the full magazine, or we will have the full magazine right there. Whew. Intense, fellas, intense. Two artists. Very, very interesting. Whenever we will have a full clip, we can even kill tortoise in full clip. So this is a beautiful stuff. This is very, very, very beautiful stuff, my lovely friends. Indeed, it is. So what do we want to do now? We kind of want to knock those trees towards here. And I'm not going to sit in those trees. I'm going to go back if Art is going to blind fire, right? That's what we want to do. Also, don't act surprised if some of them will try to flank us like this. If that would be the case, I want to check it out. Uh-huh. Tortoise is very, very close over there. And GVE is trying to run from him. I think this could be the right moment to make a hardcore pressure on this poor soul over there. Only one, it's okay. I hope he's not going to hit me. Bad decision. Why would I trade like this? That was my mistake. I cannot complain about this. I just simply can't. And the motion is over there. It's fine. Let's get one more clip right there. Or half of the clip. It's okay. Good. I knew this is going to be pretty much over when I took that one more shot over there, because I was down to fartable for Arta. But look at the score. We managed to pump solid 6,300 damage right there. And it's good. This vehicle can work in those situations when you can catch enemies which is making mistake, and then you are buds, you know, simply eliminating them and going on the reload. DPM of this tank is actually very, very good. By the way, before we got a lot of questions, Skill, why you're using the anonymizer? This is Ru server, and I said that loud and clear. I will use anonymizer in the Ru server, and in the EU server I will not use anonymizer. The main reason in the EU server why I do not use anonymizer is I don't want to take opportunity from you to meet me in the game and to say hi Skill, or say fuck you Skill, you suck. Ru server, in Ru server not many people know who I am. Counting in those 2 or 3 years of me playing in the Ru server, I met like 5 people which said hi Skill. So I don't really think it is the worst thing what I'm doing, and I'm not taking anything from community by any means, fella. So here you go. One more battle with a FOCH B. The first one was very, very good. I'm super happy with the score, although it was a bit stupid. I went for the shot into the tortoise. That was kind of stupid, but it is how it is. Could I win this battle? Debatable, but the answer is probably no. Once again, at least that's what I think, right? And here you go, we have once again the matchmaking against the tier 9s, and we are going to try to show for a tier 9s who is the boss right there. We are starting with AP clip, and more likely we are going to go PRP. You know, there is a couple of options. I think we are going to go into the middle, and the main reason why we are going into the middle, fellas, is juxt. Bravo! And the main reason why we are going into the middle is very, very simple. I think the middle is the most flexible out there, right? So, since I think it's the most flexible place, I will go there with a FOCH B. And whenever we will figure out which side is weaker, this one or this one, we are going to make a hardcore pressure there. This is the plan. This is the goal. Let's do this. Let's do this. Okay. So, What is this map? Because a lot of people hate this map a lot, right? Because pushing towards the one line can be extremely tricky, especially when you are getting side shots from over there. And I want to be that guy which is side-shotting people, right? That's who I want to be, and this is my main mission over there, right? I want to punish enemies for their stupidity, if I can say so. This is the plan, and this is the dream, fellas. By the way, speaking about Fava, do you see this guy over there? You know, I could potentially catch him, but in the same time, he could catch me, and that would be not so good. Anyways, what we are doing here, we are simply waiting until that one fort is going to go a bit more aggressive over there, and then we will try to hit his cupolas, because I cannot track him. This is the thing. Patience, patience, patience. Also, meanwhile, what do I want to highlight right there is, if enemies are going to go vroom more aggressively over there, we are going to have a flat sides on them. And as you can see, 140 over there, one into the side of the 140, 140 is going to get murdered right there. This is a very bad call by the 140. It is his loss, he messed up. Good. We found the person which is making a mistake, and then we are schnai, 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 schnai. I don't know, fellas. I mean, more I play with this vehicle, as wrong as it sounds, more I like it. But once again, I like it with a full APCRs. And yes, skill, you dirty gold noob, no skill, noob, learn to play. I like it. And what I supposed to do? You know, what I supposed to do, my lovely friends? What? Meanwhile, look at this. Auto aim and let's effing go. Boom. Good. Wait for it, wait for it, wait for it. If enemies are going to make a hardcore pressure, zoom, like this, we are going to burst them. What is the potential of the FOCH B? Potential of the FOCH B is 2,400 out of one clip if you are hitting the average rolls. It can be higher, it can be lower. And if you are missing one shot, minus 400 damage, and so on, so on. That's how everything is working with this vehicle. Interesting. You know what I am thinking now? T95. I cannot blind fire T95. It's just simply impossible. So in my opinion, it's kind of based off the time. By the way, what this 3090 is doing over there? I have a feeling he's a fucker, right? At least that's what this is the feeling which I have. So what we are going to do for this guy, we are going to help him a bit. You don't believe in me? We are going to push him into the bush over there, so he's not going to get murdered too easily. As wrong as it sounds, this will be help for that 3090. You see, he's disconnected. He's not even moving right there. So whenever he's going to be in this bush, people is not going to outspot him, and it's going to be a great help for this guy. Because I don't have anything better to do right there, at least I can help this guy to sit in the bush right there, right? Easy peasy lemon squeezy. And in the same time, we unblocked the road for ourselves to fap on the people, which is making a bit of hardcore pressure over there, like this 277, right? Patience. Whenever this 3090 is going to wake up, he is going to say, "Ooh, I'm in the bush. That's what he's going to say. By the way, we spotted this lightweight over there, and my goal would be those guys boom, boom, boom to fap on him, but probably it's not going to be the case because they are kind of busy fighting against the people over there. And you know what? I believe it's quite clear enemies are winning this side, I would say. So what we are currently waiting for, we are waiting until the enemies are going to start making a hardcore pressure like this. That's exactly what we are waiting for, fellas. And I know I have 5 in the magazine, but it's okay. I mean, one shot there, one shot there, it's completely fine. I'm just waiting for it. T62A is yelling, I am spotting this guy, and schnai. What's from that? We spotted him, but if our team is refusing to shoot, it's not very good. I mean, I might need to be a bit more aggressive over there, I guess. This might be the best thing to do over there. At least that's what I think. But one mistake, and this would be horrible, because if I'm not mistaken, the T95 is sitting over there. If I will go super aggressively from this side towards skim, I might get punished by that T49, and I might get punished by T95, or however that tank is called, right? So I'm kind of paranoid a bit, and here you go, that's what we wanted. One into the butt. One. Two. I'm going on the reload right there, because this guy is a bit paranoid. I am going to make a hardcore pressure on him, okay? He's a bit paranoid. Plus, on top of that, fellas, we have the 3090, which is going to spot if something will happen right there. So I'm relocating to this side, right? I want to start dealing with the people over there. This is our main plan in this battle. I probably was a bit too passive over there in this game. Maybe I needed to be a tiny touch more aggressive, but hey. Decisions was made already, and I cannot turn the time back, and you know what, I don't really want to turn the time back, because I'm feeling completely fine with my current performance. And so we know where all enemies are over there, and this 277 is going to make a bit of pressure right there, or at least he should make a bit of pressure over there. And we are going to simply clip the shit out of him, right? This guy eliminated this guy from the game, which is extremely good, and now we are going in. And now, fellas, we are going in. I'm trying to track this guy, actually, yes. And we are claiming the shit out of this guy life. Look at him. Look at him go. End game. Full clip of damage. Now going for this guy over there and simply eliminating him from the game. Excellent. The score is not super duper hyper turbo good, but you get the point what I'm saying. You can play with this tank a bit safer. You can play with this tank a bit more aggressiver. You can go in front and use your hit points when you actually need to. And in reality, it's not super necessary to spam the gold, but it's like 1357, you know, 1357 is the tank which is super duper hyper turbo awesome with a full gold, but it's kind of playable with AP. Same goes for this tank. In certain situations, AP would be more than fine, but sometimes it would be way better to have a gold and to meet like mouse and just dodge, deal with a mouse without even asking his name. Good performance, fellas. So as you can see, couple of battles with a FOCH B, it was very, very good in my opinion. We did everything pretty much okay, apart the last battle. Maybe that last battle was there was the fails there and there, but it is not horrible. It is good showcase of this vehicle, how you should play with a FOCH. So we played couple of battles. We have 5000 average and 300 average assisting damage, which is very, very good, and I am happy with my performance with a FOCH B. And funny fact, more I play with this tank, more I like it. Although, probably I'm going to change my mind when we are going to hit the third mark, and when we need those last 5% in order to get up to 100% of the mark of excellence. Anyways, fellas, I hope you enjoyed your daily dose of skill. I hope you like the new camera quality. Well, it's not a camera, it is lightning, right? And yeah, fellas, we are going to upgrade the stuff to the maximum, and hopefully we are going to reach the level of perfections one day. Thank you so much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill. I hope you enjoyed this one. And by the way, quick hint, what will happen this week. This week we are going to play with a lot of tier 9s. This is a hint for you. And the next week we will play a lot with the tier 8s. This is the thing. Okay, thank you so much for watching, fellas. That was your daily dose of skill, and skill is out. Peace.